Hey guys, welcome to the O'Neill Racing bike breakdown for the 2022 Yamaha YZ125, which is arguably the most anticipated bike of the year, right? Like Honda 250F lovers might argue otherwise, but this bad boy, an all new two-stroke from Yamaha. I know I'm super excited to ride it. I'm joined by Yamaha Steve Butler, the pride of Australian motocross and former factory mechanic, team manager, right? For a while. And current head of R&D at Yamaha. So Steve, what inspired Yamaha to put effort and money behind recreating the YZ125?
Well, obviously we've all been waiting a long time for a new machine, and you know, we had a new bike in 2005 that was all very cutting edge, and it's been a few refinements since then. It's been very competitive that whole time, but certainly it was ready for a makeover. So first thing you'll notice is the new ride position, more modern ride position and obviously styling, but to the new seat shape, the very flat layout, much more narrow at the radiator shrouds. So just to modernize it, and the ride position is the first thing you'll notice. And of course there's a few parts that are carried over. It has the same aluminum frame, but almost everything else is new. Suspension is more updated, more modern to suit a wide range of riders. A little bit stiffer, a little more low speed dampening that's possible now with newer suspension. Mm-hmm. New brakes, same brakes as what's on all of the big YZs now. So there's not too much of this machine that hasn't been refined, replaced, redesigned.
Okay, so every other Japanese manufacturer, shame on you, has dropped two strokes from the lineup. So A, Yamaha has maintained, and B, Yamaha has reinvested in updating the brand, or updating the machines, right? So I think the YZ250 and YZ125 are still very popular sellers in the lineup without the refinements, correct?
That's right. Irregardless of whether they're changed or not, Yamaha has still managed to sell, you know, a good number of motorcycles every year. And if you can sell a number of anything, you want to get it out there. You know, so it's been a very positive seller. And it seems like people are coming back to two-strokes. We've noticed an increase in sales, a higher demand. And you know, certainly COVID's had an influence of that. Sales are up. And yeah, realistically, it's keeping motocross simple. Like we were just talking about that yesterday. Like if everyone's riding 125s, I feel like the excitement of the fun factor is even higher level, because the roost doesn't hurt, you can ride close to your buddies, everyone's wide open, like riding it kind of to its full potential. Mm-hmm. It's thrilling. Yeah. And that's what motocross is about.
Yeah. Okay, so there's a new motor on this thing, right? New power plant. Can you tell me a little bit about it, and how does it compare, and what's improved on it?
So from the outside, the engine does appear very similar, but there's a lot of changes. Like the crankcases are different. The bolt pattern of the crankcases has changed. The bolts that hold the cylinder to the crankcase, they're spread apart a little bit further to change the angle of the exhaust port, give a bit more room for the transfer ports. So really there's none of the parts that are interchangeable, even though they look the same. So new cylinder head, cylinder, 8mm longer connecting rod, which then the cylinder is higher, the cylinder angle, so the intake, and the cylinder is laid down so the intake angle is more opened up, kind of opened up the throat, like tilted the head back a little bit.
Yeah.
So new carburetor with power jet and
Keihan now, right?
A Keihan, 38mm Keihan with power jet, also more modern with the throttle position sensor, so it can have 3D mapping. The CDI controls the power jet to where it's open from 5,000 to 9,500. It gives it additional fuel for acceleration. Then the throttle position sensor allows us to have different mapping and different throttle openings. So it's a lot of new technology for the 125, really.
Yeah. Okay, so for old guys like you and I that grew up on two strokes and everything, it's like it's pretty amazing what a modern day two stroke feels like, right? I mean, I've not ridden a bike yet. I'm sure you've spent hours and hours and hours on this thing. Your impression of it compared to the bike it replaces?
Yeah, I think they're just more modern. You know, the first thing you'll notice is the ride position. and you sit a little bit higher, it's flatter, it's slimmer. And then the suspension character, like the spring rate is up one rate, front and rear. And like I said, with the new suspension, we're able to get more low speed damping, so we're a little more hold up into the corners. The bump reaction is more slow moving. So they're all things that modern bikes do really well, is bump absorption, bottoming resistance, and then the engine power. It still maintains that really easy to ride low RPM, but it has an additional high RPM output, over rev, peak power is up. So yeah, that's what makes it there. I think the word comes back, it's more modern. Yeah.
More modern, more fun. Okay, I can't take it anymore. We're gonna clip this video so I can suit up with Cody and Umberto and get out on this bike here at Glen Helen on a beautiful November day. Steve, thanks for joining us. Guys, thanks for watching the bike breakdown presented by O'Neill.